I will begin with the correct formation of the Seiken fist. Open the hand wide and beginning with the little finger, try to bring the fingertips to the base joint of the fingers. Roll the fingers tightly. To finish, take the thumb across as if to wrap the whole fist as tightly as possible. As the fist is formed, try to feel as though the center of the Seiken is being squeezed tightly from both sides of the fist. The actual part of the fist used to strike is the area of the forefinger and the middle finger between the first and second joints. This is the area used and known as Seiken. Next is Uraken. The hand is gripped exactly the same way as the Seiken. The striking area is the area directly behind the Seiken knuckles. Depending on the situation, sometimes the whole back of the hand may also be used. Next is Shito, or knife hand. As with the Seiken, the hand is first opened widely. From this position, whereas with the Seiken, the power of the hand is concentrated towards the center, with the Shito, the feeling is as if you are trying to stretch the back of the hand. The four fingers are pressed together lightly, and the thumb is pulled towards the back of the hand. Take care not to let the thumb fold in towards the palm. The striking area is from the first joint of the little finger to the start of the wrist. The outside, inside, and center sections are used depending on the circumstances. Next is the empi, or elbow. Bend the arm tightly. The empi striking area is the front of the elbow, or, depending on the situation, the tip of the elbow, or even the back of the elbow. As far as possible, the elbow should be bent tightly. When striking, take care not to have the radius and ulna side by side. Have the forearm bones in line with the strike and facing the opponent. Next is Tetsui, or bottom fist. The Tetsui is simply the hand closed in Seiken, but striking with the Shito area. Form a tight fist and strike with the bottom of the hand. This is called Tetsui. With the nukite, the hand is formed in the same way as Shito. Take care, however, that when you strike with the nukite, if the hand is arched towards the back of the hand, as in Shito, the power will be lost on impact and you will injure the hand and wrist. So be sure to keep the hand straight. In fact, you will find that you may want to angle the hand slightly. As far as possible, make the fingertips a single unit. Concentrate fully on the fingertips as you strike. Next is shote, or palm heel. The shote is formed by first making a shuto, then bending the wrist back strongly. The striking area is not so much the center of the palm, but the heel of the palm in line with the forearm bones. Be sure to bend the wrist fully back and concentrate on the striking area at the heel of the palm. This is called shote.
Shote と言います。肉の一番厚いところですね。
The koken. The koken is the opposite of the shote. You bend the wrist forward and use this point here, this point on the wrist. This is used for blocks as well as attacks. Oyama Sosai taught that when the koken is used to the side, the thumb is on the base of the middle finger. When the koken is used vertically, the thumb is on the base of the ring finger. Be aware of this point. If you don't bend the wrist strongly, the point of the koken won't protrude correctly. Bend the wrist as tightly as possible. Next is the haito, or ridge hand. The haito uses the opposite side, the inside of the hand in the shuto position. However, whereas the thumb is pulled back in shuto, in haito the thumb is pressed in towards the palm. The striking surface is the base of the forefinger to the wrist. This is haito, the hand used on the opposite side of shuto.
に対する背に当たる分、これを背頭と呼びます。はい、中足です。
Next is 中足。The 中足 is the ball of the foot, the front part of the sole.The heel is pulled back tightly, and the foot is extended. The toes are also pulled back, so the foot strikes in line with the bones of the leg. Next is haisoku. To form haisoku, the toes are fully extended. The haisoku is simply the instep of the foot. The heel is pulled back and the toes extended strongly. This is very important to prevent injury.
この位置です。
Next is the kakato. Of course, you all know that kakato means heel. Just be aware that when using the heel for a kick, you should flex the ankle and pull the toes back strongly towards the knee, the opposite of haisoku. Depending on the circumstances, you may use the outside of the heel, or in the case of kakato otoshi, axe kick, or ushiro moashi, spin back kick, the back at the tip of the heel bone. You must be very careful not to hit and possibly injure the Achilles tendon. Take note of this.
Kakato desu.
Next is hiza, or the knee. The knee is to the lower body what the elbow is to the upper body. It is very important that you flex the leg fully when you strike with the knee. That is a fundamental of all knee techniques. Be careful not to hit the kneecap. Hit with the area around the kneecap, the front top of the knee when you thrust forward, the inside of the knee, or the top when kicking up. There are various ways to use the knee. Next is the sune, or shin. From the knee to the ankle, we use the whole shin bone. The shin is one of the weakest and most painful parts of the body, so it must be trained and hardened. If it is trained well, though, it becomes a very powerful attacking weapon, as being very effective in defense. This is sune, or shin. Next is sokuto, the knife edge of the foot. For sokuto, the ankle is flexed up and the sole turned inwards. The protruding edge of the heel is the striking area, not the front of the foot. Turn the sole in, flex the heel back strongly, and strike with the side of the heel. That is sokuto. This is very good, particularly for kicking to the side. Sokuto desu.